And welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here. Welcome to the Key Productive YouTube channel. If you are brand new and if you're a regular, welcome back. So today's video is apps of the month, and we're doing a February edition, slightly late, but we're putting it out there. We're bringing together all of the best apps on iOS, Android, and Mac for you guys to go away and download. All of them will be timestamped in the description below, so if you want to go straight to a certain application or resource, they'll be available to download below. So just before we jump in, I just wanted to thank our sponsor, who is Penji, for the February apps of the month. It was great to have Penji sponsor us this month. Now you're probably wondering, what is Penji? Now at the start of January, I was contacted by the team and they shared the resource with me. It is a tool essentially for freelancers or individuals who are looking for graphic design skills or people to go away and design stuff for them. Now, as you guys know, my theme for the year is scale, and they gave me a full 3-month trial to the resource, which I was able to delegate different items for the YouTube channel and different infographics even to other graphic designers out there. Now, I actually got about 4 or 5 graphic pieces done in the month with the graphic designers, and they helped provide a brilliant experience, and I was pretty impressed with it. Now the resource is priced, I think it's $350 a month, but there is a discount available below and you can use the link in description to get access to that. If you're looking for someone to do your design work for you, whether it's graphic design or UI design, then the team here can provide you a pretty nifty experience. I was very impressed after a month of using it. So thank you very much to Penji for sponsoring this feature. So guys, let's dive straight into the reviews. So guys, first app on the list is Aims. Now, I was very impressed by Aims. Now, it's a really unique application because its design is dead simple. It's sort of like Things 3 meets like a classic Mac sort of design on the screen. What it does for you is it allows you to project any projects or goals that you do have, and using your iPhone application actually help execute on them by giving yourself mini actions and milestones for each of those goals. Now it's a pretty impressive application, and I think the way that it's designed is gonna make it really easy for you to make definitive, clear set goals. So if you're looking for maybe a overhaul application that stands alongside your to-do list application, then this could be the one for you. So the next resource is called Fortune City, and I was quite impressed by this one because I was actually looking at habit tracking applications and actually discovered this one. Now, the idea behind this one is to gamify your bookkeeping or accounting. So for example, let's say you're looking to save, or you're looking to track how much you spend on certain items, income, expenditure, etc. Just personal finance. It's actually a neat application for that. If you're looking to get organized with that, this application basically allows you to create this metropolis or city. It's like quite gamified, and once you do that, you can start putting money into different areas and it will track all of the income and expenditure that you do have. Now it's quite fun, and it will help to make sort of this whole expenditure and income thing a lot easier to manage. And maybe if you have kids or younger that you want to help with learning about finance, this could be a good resource for that. Now the next application is called MeeTime, and they're actually the sponsor for March's apps of the month, which is pretty exciting. Now the resource is a pretty nifty way to create agendas for meetings. Now that's quite rare inside an application when you're looking for a specific tool to book meetings or even to plan meetings. It's quite hard to find, and so a lot of the time you get locked into some subscription applications, but this resource is pretty impressive. It's an iOS application that provides you with a way to quickly create a purpose for a meeting, add all the location and timings, and then have an actual timer for the meeting, as well as an agenda purpose and the direct responsibility items. Now it's quite cool because if you're looking to define like certain details and you want to share that with other people, then it's pretty useful. Now the real magic is inside the timer, which allows you to track the time of the meeting and log all of that good stuff. And it really does help you keep accountable to those meetings. But you'll hear more of that in next month's one. So the next application is Castro, and it's a podcasting application with a slight productivity twist. When you get a new podcast, it appears in your inbox, and what you can do there is choose what happens to it. It's quite a cool way to triage your podcast episodes as they come in. Now I know sometimes podcasting can be pretty manic, like all of those podcasts you have to listen to, what do I listen to, when do I listen to it, and this is a great resource to be able to clear all of that lovely stuff out. Now the application, as I know, it's available on iOS, and provides you with a pretty nifty experience, although it is a one-off payment to get access to that. Now, the next application you guys probably know already, I did a recent review of it, Dropbox Paper. Dropbox Paper is essentially a tool that allows you to create documents in Teams, share them, and make comments, notes, and bring all of the document stuff to life. It's sort of like Google Docs, but maybe a little more multimedia focused. Now, Dropbox Paper has been making waves recently, and I've been checking out their iOS application, which is pretty decent. Although it needs some slight work, it is a good experience. Now, this is available on iOS and Android, so you can download that one after this video. And finally, I've mentioned it before, but Skillshare have a really strong application, and if you're a member, you can actually download all of the classes that you have available offline. So you can go away and watch that. It's sort of like the TED app to some extent, but there are some courses and classes that you can go away and enjoy, and I know a fair amount of them that you guys will enjoy. Now, Todoist have two classes on there which are pretty impressive, all about sort of digital productivity, planning your week, and trying to get out of like a digital like stress and everything like that. I'll include all of them in the description below. Anyway guys, I hope you enjoyed this month's apps of the month. I hope that you can go away and download them. I'll include them all in the description below. I've got an exciting list for March, so feel free to stay tuned. If you like apps of the month and you want to see more of it, put a comment below and feel free to check out the playlist of previous apps of the month so you guys can go away and check out every single app we've ever reviewed here. Anyway guys, thank you so much for stopping by. Make sure to have a great week, keep productive, and I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.